Hey guys, Roger Perez, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Atletico Madrid career mode. We're last on my left off. I picked up a crucial win in my first leg in the semi-final of the Copa del Rey, and I picked up a win in the league over Celta Vigo. So in this episode, I have a league game against Langaris? Not sure how you pronounce it. And I'll have my first leg again in the Champions League against PSG. Yeah, but of course, the league game is up first.
Hi everybody, it's another challenge for Langaris. These two teams, and a challenge for
that's probably going to be the best that I can do.
Tyler, Alan Smith's with me.
Not too much of a challenge, I don't think. It should be a good game, this.
Great defensive organisation for Atletico Madrid.
Well, defending is an art.
Can you tell my defensive record is good?
This lot haven't forgotten it, that's for sure.
This Real Madrid, they're in second place on 17 goals.
Home win in their previous game against the Celta.
I'm on
5-0. The strikers were on fire. I think that'd be too much for the opposition today.
Anderson! Oh, that would be a great start. Correa will collect it, yes. Griezmann! Yes! Great start. Our 5 minutes in, and I'm already 1-0 up.
So a real captain's contribution here.
I'm really only going to be commentating over the gameplay, because I have nothing to talk about. I wish I did.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
But,
here's a chance to attack. Well, he's got support here. Here comes the cross. So the corner to come. Here it is again, Griezmann's goal.
I have no words for Oblak. Didn't even make any attempts to get to the ball there. Versus if he says, not thinking it.
Looks bad, but he's looking down.
What's the worst that could happen?
Did take a little bubble.
You dumb prick. You're lucky that didn't cost me a goal.
That's a serious situation, and on he goes.
I would have been pissed.
Here's a chance! Oh, he had a real...
Oh!
He can't knock him. He was in the right place.
I expected one or two things to happen there. I kind of expected that your man was going to take me down, but... Actually, it looked a lot closer on the first viewing. Again, the replay makes it look like he was miles away from me.
Ángel Correa. There's real threat from Atletico Madrid in these positions. Here's the chance.
Correa!
Almost grazing the top of the crossbar.
I don't know where it is. Why do I keep hitting it way too high?
The home
come
on,
team
all the
yes.
cards here, it seems.
Correa.
Especially the points that they got for winning the away game on the ground of the...
Go on. So...
Take the chance with the shot there.
Yeah, thought he might have done better there. Had a bit of time and space. Good position.
Unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. Drift. Past the post. I have no words.
Well, this attack.
Griezmann. Yes, there we go. 2-0. Well, that's what I wanted to see. Antoine Griezmann.
It should get them across the line.
Doubling. Hang up on. In the opposition.
Well, he's doubled up here.
Bagging his second of the game.
He took it in excellent style, just like the first one. Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
I mean, that's just the way of the game, isn't it? When you have a goal scorer in top form, He's gonna bag you a shit ton of goals.
We've got here on his team. Way teams.
Any team where
two defeats in a row.
We've had a season where their goal scorers did.
I just want to make sure it doesn't go on for too
mad
long.
Things.
They cope with it well defensively.
Things can tell you that. Where it be the likes of Liverpool with Luis Suarez, or Arsenal with Henry, or Van Persie, or Man United with someone like Ruud van Nistelrooy, or how Wayne Rooney, or even Chelsea, or Man City, any team. If you have a player who scores,
oh, it's a corner.
Who's the kind of goals that strikers like Griezmann can score? You're always gonna do well if they give you the best that they can. Sometimes strikers can have oxy.
Oh, it's the post.
For the majority of the time, you know you can count on that.
Well, they're in a good position here. Space to try and hit it now. What a lovely death finish that was.
Can you tell I'm struggling to find minutes to talk about? Anderson scores and make 3-0, which, might as well wrap up the points. So, Anderson's 4th or 5th goal of the season. Let's see if we... Oh, it's his 7th! I'm miles off!
Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead.
That's because of the change in formation. He had 1 goal before then. Since then, he has scored 6. Guarantee you, he's
looked very good
contributed a few assists
down
here and there as well. Correa.
It's Saul.
Saul.
Read the play well to intercept.
Oh, mistake could lead to Anderson getting a second.
Very good stop here.
He'll, the defender had to put it out. He had Griezmann breathing down his neck.
He's taken it away there with a very good tackle. Well, there's still a chance for something to happen because there's 3 added minutes. In comes the challenge.
For a throw.
Taken quickly.
Sorry I went quiet there. I don't know if you guys heard that screeching. The child just got past the block and they're screaming their head off. Clear. Really, someone's child is crying. He hopefully that person. Source. Their child out by feeding them or putting them down for a nap.
The second half brings the first half.
Those are the
two
most likely things. Maybe gas. I don't know. I couldn't tell how old the child was.
Building steadily here, keeping possession.
They were still in strollers, so that could give you that idea.
That's great.
Like I said, struggling to find things to talk about. Talking about random shit like people walking past a child screaming. That could be the cause. Or maybe they just don't like being outside. Maybe that's...
They play on with the advantage and Atletico Madrid do just that. On EA Sports very soon, the Champions Cup fixture. Atletico Madrid, they'll be facing Paris Saint-Germain away from home.
Yeah, high quality fixture this one. There won't be much quarter given.
And that's given away possession.
Foul! How's that not a foul?
Atletico Madrid now, attacking
Coke. Stay on your feet, Coke. He, this referee, is not giving anything today.
Successful tackle. It's a terrible place to give the ball away. And shoots!
Griezmann! Oh my god. Antoine, that should have been your hat trick.
And here we have quick reminder for you of EA Sports Action.
That's funny.
And La Liga Action.
Ligueras, their next league game is Barcelona. The ironic thing is, my next league game is Barcelona as well. It's after the PSG game, but it is against Barcelona.
Well, this is interesting whether the manager is just going to switch.
If you're making two substitutions, make them at the same time. Don't make one then say, ah, no, I'll make another.
Straightforwardly. Throw in coming up. I guess he was aiming for a teammate, but he certainly didn't find one. Despite protests, it's a foul by Miranda.
Yeah, very silly yellow card. I knew it as soon as I first swore, I was like, oh crap, that's going to be yellow. Oh, I have to be careful now.
Excellent header, probably deserved.
Last thing I need is a red card.
The ball in this league, I think.
Deep.
Nicolas Gaitán.
Gaitán.
On to the attack now. This could be it.
Somebody give me an option here. Salt! Oh, the block.
Promising build up until that challenge. Throw in here.
Really? Really? I was expecting you to kick it forward, man. Not out for a throw.
Good challenge here.
Let's compete the ball.
Cut out by the defender. And it's out for a throw.
Mine.
Atletico Madrid.
Yep.
Was good progress.
Good
this
place
attack.
For the throw. Correct.
Played into the middle.
Griezmann. Then Griezmann. There's the hat trick.
Three of the best. He's made them.
Gets a little.
That completes a wonderful hat trick.
Cross in from his buddy Correa. And he gets his head on it, knocks it in. Should score his hat-trick goal, or your butt makes up for it now. Oh, Antoine Griezmann. Oh, went in off the post. Didn't even notice that the first time around.
Please run it, rebounded in. So they're looking for more at 4-0. Sometimes being a favourite in a match can weigh heavily, expectation and all that. It's not a problem for this team, is it?
No, I think their manager will be delighted because they've not taken it easily at all. They've given respect to their opponents, but they've...
Oh, that's a yellow card for this player as well.
To where his teammates are lining up.
Diaz.
Referee has shown the player a yellow card.
Yeah, and that player's just got to be careful now.
Right outside the box, any closer and it's a penalty.
Koke!
What a goal that is! Griezmann's definitely getting man of the match for this game, no doubt about it.
The defenders seem to lose
hat-trick and an assist now.
From a long way out, the timing was great.
Great goal from Koke.
Get ahead of his man.
Game.
That was some header.
A top quality header. That's two top quality headers. Probably a bit better than Griezmann's because it didn't need to go in off the post. It went straight in. Third goal of the season for Koke.
If you're losing count, it's 5-0. Now the countdown is to 10 minutes left. He's coming forward with some danger. Attack is looking good.
Joe.
Now the opposition have a chance. Another turnover in play here with that interception. They'll need to try and get
good
the ball
tackle by Miranda. Correa.
There's real threat from Atletico Madrid in these positions. Maybe the cross.
Gets out wide to get the cross in, Griezmann!
It's all about goals, Antoine Griezmann.
I'm not even sure where to consider it a landmark anymore.
On target once more.
As Each career move passes, it's getting less and less special. Griezmann reaches 40 goals, becoming the
defenders caught out by it in the
fourth player to do that for me. In this FIFA, he's the fifth overall, joining Cristiano Ronaldo, Sadio Mane, and the two fellas from the Belgian career mode.
Well, the match a long time over here.
If you're wondering why I didn't include Divock Origi, he didn't make it to 40. He only got 30.
Three added minutes. There's only a minute to go. Well, they've got the ball back now in the middle of the field. There's some potential in this move.
Yeah, Antoine Griezmann gets his name on that sheet.
Well, look at that.
It's ever growing, isn't it?
Emphasizes what we've seen.
There's still plenty of time. Griezmann could become my highest scoring ever player. 50.
Never altered.
3 or something like that. Wonderful stuff. Set as like the record. And there is plenty of games left. And I'm nowhere near winning the title. I calculated it before I recorded. I still have to win about 9 more games.
Euro League.
To win the title. Of course, that could, you know, it'll vary on other results, but
Olympiacos nil.
If the team is second, which I think at the moment is Real Madrid, if they were to keep winning, I would have to win another 9 games in a row.
La Liga.
Which,
yeah, what do those results mean to
me, but
at the top of the table remain
that's the situation we are in. Not quite there to winning title just
with a game in hand on the team above. In third, Barcelona with 39 points. In fourth, Valencia with 39 points with a game in hand on the team above. In fifth, Villarreal.
I mean, depending on how you look at it.
In sixth, Real
Sociedad with 32 points.
In seventh,
one goal off season.
In eighth, Espanyol with 31 points, but only behind on goal difference.
It's very much a foregone conclusion.
With a game in hand.
You never know.
And then reading up the table, second bottom, Deportivo Alves with 18 points. Third bottom, Real Betis with 20 points.
I don't count my
bottom, Deportivo La Coruña with 23
chickens
points.
Before they hatch.
Behind. On goal difference.
To use the
bottom, Granada with 23 points.
I always just make it a personal point to never count it out because, well, he win games all the time. That could change at the drop of a hat. I mean, it doesn't seem like it's gonna, but it could. Sooner or later, it will. Sooner or later. It's one of the main reasons I want EA to introduce a higher difficulty. Because I think I've bested the league.
Well, it's a knockout stage.
I think it's safe to say I've bested.
Round of 16, it really hots up from here on in.
Well, it does, and this is where your better players would hope to step forward and really lead from the front.
When I'm an unstoppable force
in
one career mode, and in our career mode, I'm barely conceding goals.
Thiago Silva plays with Marquinhos.
I barely dropped any points.
Maria starts with Javier Pastore in the wide position.
I did.
In attack, Edinson Cavani starts. He was man of the match in the last game. Quite a few changes.
Top points recently in a off-screen career mode.
Luciano Vietto.
Weirdly enough. But,
Kelechi Iheanacho. Looking for an opening with some good control build-up.
It's not like I didn't have chances to win the game. I think I just
put it out. It's gone out for a corner.
Look at the game and
the way Atletico Madrid might go in this match, he could be really influential.
It's not like I lost the game. It was a nil-all draw. I dominated the game. I don't even think my opposition has shot on goal.
And it's a headed effort.
I don't even mean shot as in they took a shot and just didn't go on goal. They had zero shots. And I had about 30. So that tells you all you need to know.
And here's the shot.
Come to think of it, they may have been on park the bus.
We'll now have to see.
I don't know why I'm just thinking about this now. Maybe I should go on all out attack. It's too late to change it now, is it? It doesn't matter, it's enough. Screen career mode, I don't even
play like this and this goal. I'll tell you what, he looked as if he was tired.
I leisurely play, I don't even put full effort into it. The amount of times I drop points in those, it's unreal.
And that has
I've never, in a leisurely career mode, just
Thiago Silva
gone on a full-on win every game in streak. Hell, I've even lost some games in those career modes over the years.
He's coming forward.
And yes, I did those on legendary.
That attack was looking good. You
know, the game would be too easy if I did it on a lower.
Well, they're building steadily here, working away.
Of course. The lower the difficulty,
off the post,
the lower the competency of the CPU. Wait, seriously. On the lower difficulties, you can literally score a goal and then stand in the corner for the rest of the game, and the CPU won't even think to tackle you. What? How's that work? Imagine if that happened in real life. Oh, they've scored. Now, there they go into the corner with the ball. Now they're just standing there. Let's not tackle them. A 1-0 loss, that's not bad. it's weird.
Well, we're still calling them Paris Saint-Germain. Alan, I know there's a big move afoot within the club to be called Paris.
A friend of mine did an experiment
where he French football, a Paris FC already, so I don't know how they're going to work that out. But
went on the lowest difficulty.
And a team now that's consistently challenging at the top of European football and long overdue, really, because Paris has been punching.
Not sure what team he went to. I think he went with an Elite 2 team in. When I say Elite 2 team, I mean a Football Elite 2 team, you know, the lowest division in England.
Javier,
I think so, anyway. He said he was going to go with a really small team. You just see how it worked. So, he said he would win every game 1-0, score an early goal, and then stand in the corner and see if any.
The manager here has had an attractive offer to.
And sure enough.
Level, but not attractive enough for him.
He did it. Every game, 1-0, then he stood in the corner.
The extra workload.
Did the computer challenge him? Did the computer think to try and get the ball? Nope. It just left him alone in the corner. To just, as if he owned the ball. Well, and they were like, can we play? And they're like, nah. Man, he's like, just you can't play.
From close in against the
how does that work? So, yeah, lower difficulties, bit retarded, and I honestly think it's gotten to the point where.
Shot on! Kozawa.
You guys have been watching me on.
Here's Mota.
Depending on how long you've been a subscriber and how long you've been a viewer, you might have watched me from the very beginning, or you might be new and this is your first video, in which case, welcome. If you are a long-term viewer, you will. I don't think. Have I?
Looking for support.
I can't think of a game I've played. Myself, I'm controlling the team. I'm not counting sim games because I lose them all the time. Because, well, I'm simming the game. kind of foregone conclusion. And like, you're gonna lose a majority of those games.
Onto the attack now. And shoots! 3 minutes to be added on. That's a shot well off the mark.
But, I can't remember the last game I played where I lost it.
Well, that's halftime at 1-0.
I'd have to go back a few FIFAs. Probably.
Teams it's, lined up ready to go for the
second. I don't know what else to say.
Champions Cup match for
just think
a place in the quarterfinals.
I've mastered Legendary.
The Atletico Madrid player is going to be penalized here.
What the fuck?
Rabiot.
Did I miss a foul there? I'm not the only one who missed a foul there, was I? Piss off, Di Maria.
He's got his fist to it. This could be it.
Oh, yes. This is the chance. Go on, Vieto. Sweat it. Inacho! 2-0.
Fine moment for them. They've got a firmer grip on the game now.
Get in.
They're two ahead.
But yeah.
It was good competition.
I think it's time for VA to hire
down the pecking order after this.
Well, we know you're new to new hoot difficulty for career mode.
That was a
like,
big mistake.
Why is there no career mode equivalent of ultimate?
Restarting at 2-0. Thiago Motta.
Again, from and says, ultimate is so much more difficult than Legend.
What we are going to bring soon to your EA Sports is the La Liga fixture coming up for Atletico Madrid, and they'll be.
And I agree. I've played the ultimate, and it's way more difficult.
I can't see too much to split between them.
And now the shot, and that will peter out that attack. It's the goalkeeper's ball.
If I were to show you my main account for where I play my Liverpool career mode. Sometimes going
on. He might be true. And they've cut it out.
Kind of mood I feel like is. Sometimes I play. You know, okay.
Oh, he's away from his marker now. And here's the shot. Good save.
And you will see the games at the top. The majority of those are.
Possession won back by Atletico Madrid here.
It's the
this is an exercise in patience
single play.
Try to get an opening.
The wins are against the look for difficulty. But as you go up through the divisions, the difficulties get harder. And when I start seeing ultimate, I'm like, oh.
Maybe some fresh legs will do the trick.
I've gotten draws. I've gotten a couple wins. I've gotten a couple of losses. Ultimate, it compared to Legendary, is totally different. It's the difficulty we need in career mode. It is. So they need to introduce it for all forms of the game. Ultimate. Now I know Ultimate is. It was literally created for Ultimate Team. That's why it's called Ultimate.
On the ball, on the shot, for him to get a strong enough.
But I mean, come on! Introduce a career mode equivalent.
Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead.
As is, I'm playing career mode on Legendary. This is supposed to be. In the most difficult
the player, that's why it's gone out.
Thing. And the most difficult time I have on
down the wing.
their mode is if a team goes total defensive.
And the cross is in. And in comes
I might struggle to break them down. Other than that, I mean, no, they'll have a few shots here and there, or if I stop paying attention, they might get a goal. But they never beat me. I want to be challenged.
Paris Saint-Germain.
Granted, it's easier for me. He'd have easy games.
Shots on here, and the goalkeeper across to it.
Easy route.
And for another corner.
I want a difficult task. I want
regular time. He's got his shot off now. That's a good block. Great reach and a great catch.
What I accomplish, I want it to be earned and not pretty much handed to me. A silver plaque.
Well, the home team has been outplayed, and the home supporters have lost their will to support, I think.
Well, haven't they just? You could hear a pin drop here. Seen one or two heading for the exits. They're not impressed.
Real opening now.
Hey, not the person you want on the ball, is it? Thiago Silva getting forward. A 3-0 down as well, you know. I'll tell you something, he's still up there as well. So, you know, just gonna do a bit of
a minimum of 3 minutes.
Clever sleuthing here that would imaginably leave a huge fucking gap at the back of for PSG. Of course, they're trying to hold on to the ball because they know
it's
now
it's
really
like that.
And the referee, oh, fuck you off, prick. Fuck off. And that was the best chance to get the fourth goal. I don't know why. Why did they send Thiago Silva up? Why? Go all out attack. You're 3-0 down. And there's a second leg anyway.
Barcelona.
I mean,
Paris Saint-Germain.
Maybe they were thinking, oh, if we get a goal here, we can like, take it to the second leg.
Osasuna, one.
Even if we did that, I have three two. Games.
Real Madrid.
Three. I mean,
Alagar, nil.
Huh?
Las Palmas.
I have three away goals. I don't know why I said that. Three games. Oh my god. That's the end of the episode. I think it's the end of FIFA as we know it. No, I'm just kidding. Oh, but that was... I don't know. Thanks for watching. Enjoy it. My rambling and my complete botch. And I'll see you all next time. Until then, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.